to Whitley Strieber's podcast studio. I'm here doing a retrospective discussion with Whitley about his book, The Key. It's a true encounter. And Whitley, can you explain to us a little bit about what a key is?
The key is the book itself. The book is a key. It's filled with all kinds of remarkable wisdom. And the reason for this is very strange and extraordinary, and let me tell you what it is. I was on my last author tour, on the last night of the last author tour. I was in the Delta Chelsea Hotel in Toronto, Canada. I had had room service at about 9 o'clock at night and then gone to bed. And there came a knock at the door, and I assumed it was the room service waiter coming to pick up the tray. I got up and opened the door, and this man came into the room. And this man came into the room, and after a couple of seconds, I realized he's not the room service waiter because he walked right past the desk where the tray was and turned around and started talking to me. And I thought, oh dear, it's the middle of the night, and I've let a fan into my room. This, fans are great. But when a fan comes to you at 2 o'clock in the morning, that might not be the case.
Yeah.
And it might not actually be a fan.
Right.
So I was immediately thinking, I need to throw him out. And then he began to talk. And it turned out to be the most extraordinary conversation of my life. It lasted probably about 45 minutes. And he covered all kinds of things. In most of them, things that we didn't think about then, like artificial intelligence. He knew a lot about artificial intelligence. And I asked him at one point if he was an intelligent machine. And he said something that is so important to us right now, all these years later. He said, oh, if I was an intelligent machine, I would deceive you. And I think that if AI ever develops general intelligence, human level intelligence, the last thing it's going to let us know is that truth.
Wow.
It will hide that. And there were so many other things. He laid out what climate change was and what would happen. And I've watched it happen.
Mm-hmm.
I wrote a book with Art Bell called Superstorm, which reflected what I learned from him about this. And it's happening all around us right now.
Mm-hmm.
So this book, The Key, and it's so filled with just, you can open it to almost any page, and the wisdom is absolutely marvelous.
Is what you wrote then based off of these things that this man shared with you?
Yes, this is a conversation.
Wow.
Like I asked him, what is consciousness? And he said, self-realization. A fully self-realized being understands the whole creation, for it is completely present everywhere, which is a really interesting and unusually deep vision of consciousness. It goes far beyond where we usually take that idea, and this whole book is like that.
Wow.
What happened was this. We had the conversation. I took some notes that were rather cryptic in retrospect, and then the next morning I immediately called Anne, because I knew from what I had studied already at that point about memory that I would soon decide that this had never happened because it was such a high strangeness experience. But understand, this man was looked normal. And he talked normally. He didn't, like, it was not telepathic or anything like that. So, but I still was afraid I would forget it or decide it had never happened. And I told Anne all about it. Then I came home and she kept saying, well, you need to write the conversation down. You need to write the conversation down. By 3 or 4 months later, I decided it had never happened. She said, no, you told me to tell you that it did happen. You told me the morning after. And she kept at me for about a year.
Wow.
And finally, I sat down and I said to myself, how do I do this? How do I write this down? It's too late. So I took out the notes, and when I touched the paper with my finger, the whole conversation came back to me, and I wrote it all out in 2 days. And this, here it is. This is the key. Mm-hmm. That's the story of the key.
That's amazing. Wow. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. That was, the persistence of Anne to keep on you, to write it, and the strangeness of the event, the prophetic conversation. I mean, it's really amazing. Thank you for watching. Thank you for enjoying this conversation that Whitley has about his strange encounter. And we hope you join us for more.